Thank you. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Bonjour, mesdames et messieurs. Je m'appelle David Ragsdell. Je suis maréchal de l'université et je suis heureux de vous accueillir en nom de l'Université McGill à la cérémonie de collation de grade du printemps 2023. Pour la faculté de droit, la cérémonie va bientôt commencer. My name is David Ragsdell. I am a university marshal, and I am pleased to welcome you on behalf of McGill University to the spring 2023 convocation ceremony for the Faculty of Law. The ceremony will start shortly. Dans quelques instants, je vous parlerai de la séquence des événements qui se dérouleront pendant la cérémonie. Mais permettez-moi d'abord de vous demander de vous joindre à moi pour applaudir le Brian Sand Quintet. In just a few moments, I will tell you about the sequence of events that will take place during the ceremony. But first, let me ask you to join me in giving the Brian Sand Quintet a very warm round of applause. La cérémonie commencera avec l'entrée de la fête de la plateforme et se terminera avec son départ. Et juste avant que le cortège d'honneur n'entre, je vous demanderai à tous de vous lever. The ceremony will begin with the entrance of the platform party and end with its departure. And just before the platform party enters, I will ask you all to stand. Une fois que les membres du cortège d'honneur auront pris place ici sur scène, le professeur Trevitaire. Once the members of the platform party have taken their places here on the stage, Professor Trevino will sing the university song. Le chancelier John McCall McBain ainsi que le principal Deep Saney prononceront chacun quelques mots. Quelques prix seront remis, suivi du discours de collation des grades prononcés pour le récipiendaire d'un doctorat honorifique. The Chancellor, John McCall McBain, as well as the Principal, Deep Saney, will each say a few words. Some awards will be presented, followed by the convocation address given by the honorary degree recipient. Nous procéderons ensuite à la remise des diplômes rang par rang en partant de l'avant et en remontant vers l'arrière. We will then proceed to award the diplomas row by row, starting from the front and moving to the back. Diplômés, vous serez guidés hors de vos sièges au moment opportun. Avant de monter sur scène, vous devez séparer votre carte nom en deux. Vos remettre une partie au lecteur ou à la personne qui assiste le lecteur au pupitre à votre gauche. Et après avoir traversé la scène, vous remettrez l'autre partie à la personne en bas des escaliers qui vous remettra votre diplôme. Graduates, you will be guided out of your seat at the appropriate time. Before going on stage, you should separate your lineup card in two. You will give one part to the reader or to the person assisting the reader at the lectern on your left. And after crossing the stage, you will give the other part to the person at the bottom of the stairs who will give you your degree. Pour terminer la cérémonie, le secrétaire général, Edita Rogowska, prononcera quelques remarques de clôture. Le professeur Trevino dirigera le chant de l'hymne national et le cortège d'honneur suivra le joueur de cornemuse jusqu'au campus. To end the ceremony, the Secretary General, Edita Rogowska, will make a few closing remarks. Professor Trevino will lead the singing of the national anthem, and the platform party will follow the bagpiper out onto the campus. Une fois que le cortège d'honneur est parti, les diplômés partiront ensuite rangée par rangée en commençant par les rangées arrière et en continuant vers l'avant. voulait ne pas essayer de sortir tant qu'un huissier n'a pas indiqué qu'il est temps pour votre rangée de partir. Once the platform party has left, the degree recipients will then leave row by row, starting with the back rows and proceeding toward the front. Please do not try to exit until an usher has indicated it is time for your row to leave. J'invite maintenant le doyen des étudiants, Robin Beach, à vous informer des mesures de sécurité mises en place dans le cas très improbable d'une urgence. Robin.
Merci. Welcome to McGill and this year's convocation. Congratulations on the success of your graduating family member or friend. My name is Robin Beach, and my privilege is to tell you about our emergency evacuation procedures. Bienvenue à McGill et à la cérémonie de collation des grades de cette année. Nous sommes ravis de vous accueillir. Je m'appelle Robin Beach et on m'a demandé de vous informer des procédures d'évacuation. If an evacuation is required, the registrar will announce this to you. You will then be required to leave the tent immediately. Please follow the instructions of the security officers and the ushers. Please don't follow the graduates. They will be evacuated to a different location. Ushers and security officers will lead you to the field across the street from the tent. Leave all baby strollers behind, but you can take your children with you. You may refer to the evacuation map at the back of your program for more information. If you need assistance at any point in time, please speak with an usher or security officer. Once the emergency is over, information will be posted on the McGill website to inform you of what will happen next. Si une évacuation des lieux devenait nécessaire, le registraire en ferait l'annonce. Vous devrez alors quitter la tente sans tarder. Suivez les instructions des placeurs et des agents de sécurité. Ne suivez pas les diplômés, car ils seront dirigés vers un autre pavillon. Les placeurs et les agents de sécurité vous dirigeront sur le terrain en face de la tente. Laissez toutes les poussettes sur place. Vous trouverez le plan d'évacuation au verso de la programme. Si vous avez besoin d'assistance, veuillez vous adresser à un agent de sécurité ou un placeur. Une fois la situation d'urgence passée, des annonces seront publiées sur le site web de McGill. Je vous remercie de votre attention. Félicitations aux diplômés. Thank you for your attention. Have a wonderful day. And once again, congratulations to our graduates.
Nous allons maintenant recevoir un court message de l'Association des diplômés de McGill. We will now have a short message from the McGill Alumni Association.
As an alumnus, I'm proud to celebrate your McGill journey, and I echo the sentiments of everyone who ever graduated from our university with just three words.
You made it!
As a graduate, you're part of something unique, the McGill Alumni Association.
Profiterez donc des avantages auxquels ont droit tous les diplômés et serez ainsi prêts à écrire un nouveau chapitre de votre vie.
Your Alumni Association is an amazing community of more than 300,000 alumni
in over 180 countries.
The global network that we share opens up a world of possibilities and connections.
L'Association des diplômés de McGill propose également des activités stimulantes et vous guidera avec des activités enrichissantes de mentorat et de réseautage.
Whether you're near campus or halfway around the world, you can easily stay connected through the MAA. Just follow us on social media and share your news.
We are here to celebrate you, cheer you on, and help you reach your next milestones. Welcome.
Welcome.
Bienvenue parmi nous.
Welcome.
Bienvenue parmi nous.
And congratulations on being a part of McGill's graduating class of 2023. Bienvenue aux nouveaux diplômés et félicitations à la promotion 2023 de McGill.
Le cortège d'honneur sera bientôt en route et je vous demanderai de vous lever quand ils seront proches.
The platform party will soon be on its way and I will ask you then to rise when they get close.
Voulez-vous lever? Please stand.
my praise loud in thy honor. Voices we raise long through the ages remain, if God will. Queen of the colleges, dear old McGill.
Please be seated. Veuillez vous asseoir. Thank you, Professor Trevino, for your wonderful performance of the university song. I was glad to see that everybody seems to know the words this year. Bienvenue à tous les diplômés, leurs familles, proches, amis. Notre principal et vice-chancelier, Deep Saini, Maryse Bertrand, président du Conseil des gouverneurs et membre de la faculté. À titre de chancelier émérite et au nom de l'Université McGill, bienvenue à notre magnifique campus du centre-ville pour célébrer la cérémonie de remise des diplômés 2023 de la 20 000, mon Dieu, je saute des années, 20 023 de la Faculté de Droit. As Chancellor Emeritus of McGill University, I welcome you to our beautiful air-conditioned downtown campus to celebrate the class of 2023 graduating from the Faculty of Law. And good afternoon to each and every one of you. I extend a warm welcome to all of you, parents, friends, and partners, of today's guests of honor, our graduates. Indeed, I particularly welcome you who are about to become McGill's most recent alumni. En cette journée mémorable, c'est un immense honneur pour moi d'être ici et de vivre avec vous cette étape importante de votre vie. Now, I have a keen appreciation of the importance of this day and of the memories that you will keep with you of this moment in your life. Because once upon a time, when dinosaurs ruled the land, I was sitting in the audience as part of a graduating class at McGill. I took much the same journey as you to arrive at this day. Although in my case, I remember calling my friends with a rotary dial phone, writing essays on a typewriter, and taking my graduation photos with a film camera. And some considerable time later, I returned on two occasions as the parent of McGill graduates, and like all parents here today, I was beaming with pride. And now, as Chancellor Emeritus, I have the privilege of attending convocation ceremonies each year. So you could say that I've seen graduation from just about every angle. Et maintenant, à titre de chancelier émérite, j'ai le privilège d'assister aux cérémonies de collation des grades chaque année. Nous pouvons donc affirmer, sans crainte de nous tromper, que ces cérémonies n'ont plus de secret pour moi. Whether you as a graduate or a parent or a chancellor, the occasion remains for me a richly deserved celebration of hard work, commitment, sacrifice, and achievement. So bravo and well done to each and every one of you. Today, you can appropriately reflect on the curiosity, the intellect, and the energy that got you to McGill in the first place and that has made you successful while you've been here. Along the way, you've been exposed to superb teachers and researchers, and you've had the chance to engage in critical thinking with others and to reflect on your views about our world and your place in it. This, I hope you'll agree, was a wonderful opportunity made more special because it happened right here at McGill. As alumni, it will soon become obvious to you that McGill enjoys a unique reputation in this increasingly competitive and international world that you're about to step into. And McGill garners remarkable respect and admiration, especially internationally. En tant qu'anciens étudiants et diplômés, il vous deviendra bientôt évident que McGill jouit d'une réputation unique dans ce monde de plus en plus concurrentiel et international dans lequel vous êtes sur le point d'entrer. McGill suscite un respect et une admiration remarquables, particulièrement à l'international. But regardless of what and where your next step is, I hope that you will look on your years here as being happy, productive, and rewarding ones. Of one thing I'm confident, and that is that few investments will provide you with as much of a return both in financial and personal satisfaction. And when you do think about McGill, I'd ask you to remember that most every experience that you've had that was core to McGill's mandate has been enhanced and shaped by those who've gone before you. I speak particularly of those graduates who supported this university financially and with the gift of their time. But for some unknown reason, we're quite adept at resisting any kind of sectarian affinity for the institution where we got our education. And surely it's about time for Canadians to stop just liking their universities and to start loving them. Graduation is not just a rite of passage, but rather an inauguration into a very special community. So today I ask you to start loving your university, or perhaps I should say to keep on loving McGill, whether you find yourself in Paris, London, Hong Kong, Toronto, Vancouver, Boston, or even here in Montreal. Remember that your ongoing attachment to McGill is what will ensure that our university maintains its enviable reputation as one of the leading institutions of higher learning in the world. Votre attachement continu fera en sorte que notre université maintienne sa réputation enviable en tant que l'un des principaux établissements d'enseignement supérieur au monde. But it's not just a one-way street. McGill can and will be of assistance to you in your career development. In each of the cities I've mentioned, and in many others, there exists a branch of the McGill Alumni Association, and I urge you to take advantage of your degree and to get involved. Perhaps it's an experienced and thoughtful mentor that you're seeking, or exposure to a leading local expert in your chosen field, or maybe just to get together with fellow graduates to swap stories of your days on campus. Whatever it may be, you'll gain access to a worldwide network of all of whose members share one thing in common, the unique McGill experience. To each of you here this afternoon, you who will shortly formally take your place amongst the more than 300,000 McGill graduates in more than 185 countries around the world, my most sincere congratulations on your achievement, and I wish you every success as you embark on the next exciting phase of your lives. Merci et bonne chance. It's now my pleasure to invite Deep Sani, Principal and Vice Chancellor of McGill University, to address the audience. J'aimerais maintenant inviter Deep Sani, Principal et Vice-Chancelier, à s'adresser à l'auditoire.
Merci beaucoup, Monsieur le Chancelier. Thank you very much, Chancellor Michael Mean. Bienvenue et félicitations à nos finissantes et finissants pour la promotion de 2023. Congratulations to the class of 2023. And a warm welcome to you all, your family, your friends, as well as to our esteemed guests who have joined here today. Quel plaisir de célébrer ensemble vos réalisations, les réalisations de nos gradués. And what an honor it is for me to preside over my first set of convocation ceremonies as Principal and Vice Chancellor of McGill University. It feels like just yesterday that I too was a proud McGill parent sitting under this big tent, like many of you who are here today, and watching my daughter receive her McGill degree. So to the families, I know exactly how you feel. That feeling of elation in your hearts right now is very familiar. Being a McGill graduate is a distinction that is not easily earned. It requires diligence, determination, and commitment. And our graduates, you know it better than anybody else, that this is a university that's not an easy one to get into, and it's even a harder one to get out of. You have demonstrated all of these qualities, qualities of diligence, determination, and commitment throughout your studies, and even more so during the pandemic. You adapted with agility, and you adapted to unprecedented circumstances. You met these difficulties with strength and prevailed to reach your goal, and that's why you're here today. In reaching this milestone, take a moment to really appreciate the meaning and the weight of your accomplishments. Be proud of yourselves for your remarkable efforts and for your resilience. Relish in the excitement, even that nervous feeling that you may be feeling right now that comes with a future that is full of possibilities, but perhaps also uncertainties. And importantly, very importantly, recognize the many people who have helped you get here, your family, and your friends who supported you in your studies, as well as your professors, librarians, and university staff. So graduates, please join me in putting our hands together in a big round of applause for all these people who have supported you. Chers finissants, vous avez mérité une place bien à vous dans l'histoire de notre McGill. Depuis plus de 200 ans, cette histoire s'enrichit de l'excellence de nos étudiants et étudiantes, professeurs, membres du personnel et bien entendu de nos diplômés. This greatness, which I have had the pleasure of witnessing firsthand since joining the university in April, is what I call that special McGill character. This is a community that is renowned for questioning established paradigms, for embracing difficult challenges, and for constantly pushing the frontiers of creativity and innovation, and in doing so with a focus on improving the societies it serves. Graduates, as you begin this next chapter in your lives, think of how you can leverage this special McGill character, which each of you embodies, to make your communities and our world a better place. More than ever, our world needs bright, passionate, creative, and empathetic people. People who are capable and driven to address the pressing challenges of our times. Challenges that include the transitioning of this world to more sustainable energy sources, developing new frameworks to ensure the more ethical use of artificial intelligence, or safeguarding our democracy and civil order in this post-truth era. Graduates, take what you have learned during your time at McGill and use your education to leave this imperfect world better than you found it. And always make sure that the opportunities afforded to you by your education do not enhance your life alone, but also the lives of others. I recognize that this is a big ask, and meeting it will not be easy. Doing so will indeed demand a great deal of you. But your generation has demonstrated time and again that you have what it takes to effect real transformative change. Finissant et finissant, nous avons aujourd'hui beaucoup de raisons de célébrer, car aujourd'hui, vous devenez le diplômé de McGill. Vous vous joignez à un réseau actif composé de quelques 300 000 personnes établies un peu partout sur la planète. Je vous invite à maintenir un lien fort avec votre alma mater. Ensemble, nous continuerons à façonner le troisième siècle de McGill. Graduates, the future is yours to shape. Follow your curiosity wherever it may take you, and above all, keep learning. We cannot wait to hear where your journey takes you and what amazing things you will do in the future, both for yourselves, but more importantly, for the world. Alors, félicitations, congratulations to all of you, and all the best.
Thank you, Principal Sani. We'll now proceed with the teaching award presentations. I invite Professor Rosalie Jukier to present the first award winner. Next, Angela Campbell, Associate Provost, Equity and Academic Policies, will present our second award winner. I invite the winners to please stand when their name is called and join the principal at center stage. Professor Jukier.
Thank you, Mr. Chancellor Emeritus. Monsieur le Vice-Chancelier, c'est un grand honneur et un immense plaisir de vous présenter le professeur Jeremy Boulanger Bonelli, récipiendaire du prix John W. Durnford pour l'excellence en enseignement. That Professor Boulanger Bonelli is the Law Students Association's choice as this year's winner of the Durnford Teaching Award is not surprising, particularly when you read the student testimonials about his pedagogy, his approachability, and his commitment to his students' learning. What is surprising and even a bit astonishing is that Professor Boulanger Bonelli, or Prof. Bibi as he is known, has won this prestigious award in his first year, correction, first semester of teaching as a faculty member. En lisant des témoignages d'étudiants, il y a trois thèmes qui ressortent. Clarté, accessibilité et feedback. Le mot « clair » figure dans chaque témoignage, généralement précédé de mots d'emphase tels qu'extrêmement ou cristal. Son accessibilité est aussi notée par ses étudiants, non seulement par le fait qu'il est toujours disponible pour répondre à leurs questions ou pour s'engager dans des discussions, mais aussi parce que ces PowerPoints sont décrits comme épurés et ces cours enregistrés et mis à leur disposition. As for feedback, not only is it detailed and precise, but he is willing to give feedback to students who aren't even taking his course. In class, he welcomes everyone to participate in lively and constructive debate. As one student put it so well, he cares so much about his students. The whole class just loves him. 11 years ago, Jeremy Boulanger Bonelli was a first-year student in my contractual obligations class, a course he is currently teaching. Just as nothing makes a parent feel better than seeing their own child succeed, Nothing makes a teacher prouder and more delighted than seeing their own former student turn into an exceptional pedagogue in their own right. Mr. Vice Chancellor, it is with personal and institutional pride that I present Professor Boulanger Bonelli as this year's winner of the John W. Durnford Teaching Excellence Award.
Monsieur le vice-chancelier, c'est un honneur et une grande source de fierté de vous présenter ma collègue, mon amie, mon ancien professeur et ma mentor, la professeure Shauna Van Praagh, récipiendaire du prix du principal de l'Université McGill pour l'excellence en enseignement. Enseignante exceptionnelle dès le début de sa carrière, la professeure Van Praagh a reçu le prix John W. Durnford pour l'excellence en enseignement en 1995, 2 ans seulement après avoir commencé son parcours à McGill. Depuis, elle a enseigné à plus de 2500 étudiants, notamment à travers des cours tels le droit des obligations extra-contractuelles, Advanced Common Law, les fondements du droit, la diversité sociale et le droit, la théorie du droit féministe, les enfants et le droit, la méthodologie juridique et finalement le Legal Education Seminar, cours hérité de notre ami et collègue bien-aimé, le regretté Rod MacDonald. An exemplary research supervisor, she has trained hundreds of postdoctoral, graduate, and senior undergraduate students. Several of them, including yours truly, found her love of law teaching contagious and went on to their own careers as law professors. An academic leader, Professor Van Praagh's tenure as Associate Dean of Graduate Studies enriched graduate student life and learning at McGill Law. As a young assistant professor in 1995, she chaired the faculty's Curriculum Review Committee, designing the blueprint for McGill's trans-systemic program, which became renowned as a model of legal education the world over. Je pourrais vous citer toutes ses réalisations, mais cela ne vous donnerait pas un portrait aussi riche de sa personnalité d'enseignante que peuvent le faire les évaluations de ses étudiantes. En voici juste 2 exemples. To me, you are akin to a lighthouse, un point de repère amidst a journey on the mer de la connaissance, at times calm and parfois rocked by tempests. For that, I thank you. And another student wrote as follows during the COVID-19 pandemic. You have my eternal gratitude for making my first 2 years of legal education so incredibly thought-provoking and inspirational. Your classes and our weekly conversations brighten some of the darkest moments of the past few years. Your kindness, thoughtfulness, and resolute pedagogical leadership are truly admirable. This year marks 30 years since this amazing faculty member began her career at McGill, 3 decades as a sterling model of law teaching. As her former student, I see her successes as rooted in 3 attributes. First, encouraging students to look for the right questions rather than simply the right answers. Deuxièmement, sa vision de l'enseignement comme une façon de vivre en dialogue avec tous ceux qui l'entourent et d'être toujours en mode d'apprentissage. And third, her invitation to lean into life's messiness. Jurists love taxonomies, but most concepts and issues and even people are not squeezed into neat static categories, and there's no singular, seamless narrative. There are countless stories and perspectives. Professor Van Praagh invites us, her students, to meet those stories and perspectives with curiosity, integrity, and empathy, and to become better jurists and better people in so doing. Mr. Vice Chancellor, it is my true pleasure to present to you Professor Shauna Van Praagh, winner of the Principal's Prize for Excellence in Teaching in the Full Professor category.
Well, thank you to the presenters, and of course, warmest congratulations to this year's winners on their well-deserved recognitions. I now invite Martha Crago, Vice Principal of Research and Innovation, to present the winner of the Principal's Prize for Outstanding Emerging Researchers. Vice Principal Crago.
Thank you, Mr. Chancellor Emeritus. Mr. Vice Chancellor, I present to you Professor Ignazio Cofoni. Ignazio Cofoni is Canada Research Chair in Artificial Intelligence Law and Data Governance, and an assistant professor in the Faculty of Law. As an expert in the law of privacy and artificial intelligence, Professor Cofoni's research focuses on privacy harms and on algorithmic decision making to explore how law should adapt to technological and economic change. AI algorithms are shown to improve efficiency and sustainability, but they can also cause harm to marginalized groups. His goal is to prioritize human rights through proper governance of data and reduce discrimination in the deployment of AI. His research is incredibly timely, as the gap between innovation and legal research in the field of AI is widening at a rapid speed. Professor Cofoni exhibits an exceptional record of accomplishments as an early career researcher. In addition to teaching and supervising multiple students, he has produced numerous high-quality journal articles, policy reports, academic blogs, and a book that will be published in December. His research is frequently mentioned in the press, and he's regularly invited to give national and international presentations and workshops. With a strong passion for equity, diversity, and inclusion, he serves as the chair of McGill's subcommittee on queer people and has organized legal workshops with a commitment to inclusion and broad representation. Professor Cofoni's tireless contribution to McGill's research community makes him a worthy recipient of this prize. Mr. Vice Chancellor, it is my honor to present Professor Ignazio Cofoni, winner of the Principal's Prize for Outstanding Emerging Researcher.
Congratulations, Professor Cofoni, on your truly great accomplishment. We'll now proceed with the honorary degree presentation. L'Université McGill est ravie de célébrer les réalisations de Christiane Taubira, Robert Leckie, doyen de la faculté de droit, présentera à notre invité distingué, à qui sera décernée la reconnaissance la plus haute que l'Université McGill a le pouvoir d'accorder. Et j'invite Christiane Taubira à me rejoindre sur la scène pour la présentation du doctorat honorifique. Dean Leckie.
Mr. Chancellor Emeritus, I present to you Christiane Taubira, a trailblazer dedicated to civil rights and equality. Born in 1952 and raised by a single mother in poverty in French Guiana, she began her political career in the former French colony in 1978 as a member of the Mouvement Guyanais de Décolonisation. She founded the Guyanese Walwahie Party and was first elected as a member of the French National Assembly for French Guiana in 1993. She was re-elected for several terms and also served as a member of the European Parliament from 1994 to 1998. One of the most formidable speakers in the history of the National Assembly, she had a charismatic oratory style marked by literary references. Christiane Taubira rose to national prominence when she introduced a bill recognizing slavery and the slave trade as a crime against humanity. This became the Taubira Law in 2001. France subsequently incorporated the history of slavery into national school curricula. May 10th, the anniversary of enactment of the Taubira Law, is now the National Day of Remembrance of the slave trade, slavery, and their abolition in France. La carrière de Christiane Taubira a été une succession de premières. Première femme élue députée de Guyane à l'Assemblée nationale française. Première personne noire à être nommée ministre de la Justice et à se présenter à l'élection présidentielle. Madame Taubira a été nommée ministre de la Justice par le président François Hollande en 2012 et elle s'est rapidement imposée comme l'une des voix les plus franches et les plus progressistes de son gouvernement. En 2013, elle a présenté un projet de loi légalisant le mariage entre personnes de même sexe. Au cours de débats houleux qui s'en sont suivis, Madame Taubira a essuyé d'intenses attaques racistes de la part des médias et d'une partie de la société française. Elle a persévéré avec verve, dignité et grâce. Madame Taubira lived by her principles once more in a very public way in 2016. Following the November 2015 terrorist attacks in Paris, it was proposed to amend the Constitution to strip their French citizenship from dual citizens convicted of terrorism. Viewing the amendment as hasty and a violation of the Republic's fundamental commitments, Ms. Taubira resigned as Justice Minister. A prolific author, Ms. Taubira has written more than 10 books on slavery and equality. Awards conferred on her include the Prix International des Droits de l'Homme in 2017 and the Prix Littéraire Anthony Atkinson in 2020, awarded to authors whose work has significantly advanced public debate on economic and social inequalities. In 2019, she received the Prix Laurent McCutcheon from Montreal's Fondation Emergence, awarded to a public figure for major contributions in the fight against homophobia and transphobia. Christiane Taubira has led a distinguished and courageous career in public service, exemplified by her groundbreaking achievements, and she continues to make an impact on the global stage. Mr. Chancellor Emeritus, I present to you Christiane Taubira so that you may confer on her the degree of Doctor of Laws, honoris causa.
J'invite maintenant notre diplômé, très récent, de l'Université McGill, à prendre la parole. Madame Taubira.
Monsieur le chancelier émérite, monsieur le principal et vice-chancelier, Madame la Présidente du Conseil des gouverneurs, Mesdames, Messieurs, membres du cortège d'honneur, Mesdames, Messieurs de la Fondation Émergence et mon souvenir, chers parents, chers invités, et vous particulièrement, chers finissantes et finissants, j'ai l'habitude de m'exprimer en public, mais je dois reconnaître que j'éprouve une profonde émotion à prendre part à cette cérémonie de collation des grades par laquelle, entre autres, vous m'accueillez au sein de votre communauté universitaire. Ainsi, mes premiers mots sont de gratitude pour le privilège d'être désormais des vôtres et de fierté pour entrer dans cette maison qui a laissé ses empreintes sur une douzaine de prix Nobel, sur des prix Pulitzer, sur des astronautes, des juges à la Cour suprême, des médaillés olympiques, des lauréats d'Oscars et autres Grammy Awards, bref, sur d'éminentes personnalités dans les arts, les lettres, les sciences, les sports, qui rayonnent aussi bien à l'étranger qu'au Canada, aussi sur des premiers ministres fédéraux, et bien entendu sur l'incomparable et irrésistible Leonard Cohen. Je suis extrêmement heureuse d'être ici. Pour cette courte allocution, je vous dirais que ce qui me touche le plus, c'est l'engouement qui demeure chez les jeunes générations pour apprendre le monde, pour le comprendre, et plus que pour s'y poser avec leurs projets personnels et leurs ambitions légitimes, pour l'occuper en pleine conscience d'appartenance et comprendre ce que ce monde peut attendre d'elle et d'eux. À vous donc, chères finissantes et finissants, mon propos s'adresse en particulier, même s'il s'adresse à chacun d'entre vous dans cette salle. Je serai brève, mais je vais essayer d'être claire et stimulante parce que je voudrais réveiller ou éveiller chez vous le désir d'approfondir cette réflexion. On ne peut vous dissimuler l'état du monde, ni ses potentialités, ni ses opportunités, ni non plus sa brutalité et sa violence. Et notez bien que je distingue la brutalité de la violence. Ces mots ne sont pas synonymes. Leurs différences ne sont pas simplement sémantiques. Elles sont conceptuelles, c'est-à-dire que ces mots recouvrent des réalités différenciables. Et ces différences deviennent évidentes lorsqu'on observe les confrontations sociales et les relations entre le pouvoir et la société et entre la société et le pouvoir. C'est ainsi qu'on voit bien les violences dans l'espace privé, les violences sexistes, sexuelles, familiales, les violences dans l'espace public sous les yeux de tous, les violences légales aussi. Et notez que je ne dis pas légitimes, parce que je pense que les violences légales doivent prouver leur légitimité dans chaque situation, en tout cas en particulier dans les démocraties et dans les états de droit. C'est donc très clairement, vous l'avez compris, la question de la relation entre la force et le droit. Dès le début de l'organisation des sociétés qu'on dit modernes, les philosophes, plus encore peut-être que les juristes, se sont interrogés sur les relations entre la force et le droit. Blaise Pascal, un philosophe, a essayé de résumer cette difficulté de relation en disant qu'il faut faire aller ensemble la justice et la force pour que ce qui est juste soit fort et que ce qui est fort soit juste. Je pense pour ma part qu'au regard de la conflictualité sociale, cela demeure une aporie. Mais c'est une question qui est encore d'actualité. Elle est posée aux autorités multinationales tous les jours par des violations d'accords, de conventions, de traités, de frontières, de principes. Elle est posée à ces autorités par la violation de la Charte des Nations Unies. Et évidemment, la force et le droit conservent leur relation organique, qui peut être antagonique ou qui peut être dialectique. Elle est antagonique dans ces situations où la force contredit absolument le droit. C'est le cas de la plupart des conflits armés. Cicéron, d'ailleurs, disait que les lois se taisent quand parlent les armes. Et elle est dialectique dans les cas où la force est la condition du droit. C'est le cas des forces d'interposition des Nations Unies, par exemple, ou de toute force qui s'interpose entre des parties en cas de guerre considérée comme une situation anormale, pour revenir à une situation normale de droit commun. J'espère, jeunes finissantes et finissants en particulier, mais chacun d'entre vous, que vous aurez de l'appétence pour creuser ces questions et mieux comprendre le fonctionnement du monde et l'état de gouvernance du monde et les améliorations qu'il faut y apporter. Et si vous avez cette appétence, je me permets deux incises. Une, pour dire que dans les sociétés qu'on a appelées traditionnelles, avant leur altération ou leur disparition, je pense ici par exemple aux sociétés autochtones, le droit, le jugement, la justice
était prononcée par une autorité, par l'expression publique et consensuelle. Sans les idéaliser, il faut noter que l'autorité morale et consensuelle pouvait suffire. La deuxième assise est plus contemporaine. Elle concerne l'état du Chiapas au Mexique, où se prodigue une forme de justice qui prononce des jugements et des sanctions sans recours à la force. J'espère que vous aurez envie, le goût, d'approfondir cette question et d'apporter votre contribution pour que le monde dans lequel nous vivons soit bien meilleur. And now, just a few words about quite something else. I'm so happy and so glad to be here in Montreal that I spend every and all evening attending an artistic or cultural event. In these days, you offer a Festival Transamérique, an anarchist festival too, and also plays in the theaters and opera program and all these movies in the cinematheque and in the cinemas and all kind of form of artistic expression. Every evening I go somewhere, and every time, whatever what I see, whatever what I watch, I feel like making the same fruitful and peaceful experience of being linked with others, being connected with myself. It's a path to my inviting identity, mon identité hospitalière, and to others' identity. It's a way to learn life. And let's not forget poetry. It's such a powerful, such a sensitive way, first, to understand life and to understand the others. Let's don't neglect tenderness. Don't neglect tenderness. And thank you, everyone, for this official ceremony, which is so both solemn and warmful. Thank you.
Merci, Madame Taubira. Merci de votre discours vraiment magistral. Et vous comprenez par la réaction de l'auditoire que vos propos étaient bien appréciés, tant sur le plan de la présentation elle-même, mais aussi sur le plan du contenu. Alors, c'est une leçon pour nous tous, surtout pour les gens qui travaillent dans le monde public au Canada, à suivre l'exemple que vous nous avez démontré aujourd'hui. We'll now proceed with the conferral of academic degrees. Angela Campbell, Associate Provost, Equity and Academic Policies, will begin the formal proceedings. Professor Campbell.
Thank you, Mr. Chancellor Emeritus. I am delighted to invite the students graduating from the Faculty of Law for the conferral of their degrees. Convocation is a truly joyous event in the circle of our university's life, particularly here at McGill, where we have such talented and accomplished students. Every student crossing the stage this afternoon will be greeted by the Chancellor Emeritus, the Principal, or the Chair of the Board of Governors. Students receiving their first degree shall remove their mortarboard or their hat. At center stage, they will be symbolically capped, signaling ceremonially the conferral of the degree. Students who've already earned a university degree shall keep their mortarboard on and will be congratulated by a tap on the shoulder. The parchment or the degree itself is given to the students after they have a photo taken and leave the stage. You may see some of our students wearing red or white scarves. All self-identifying Indigenous students, First Nations, Inuit, and Métis are entitled to wear graduation scarves at convocation, in the community, and at any and all future McGill events that they attend. This spring convocation here at McGill, we are truly proud and delighted to welcome 71 Indigenous graduates into our community of McGill alumni. En vertu des pouvoirs qui me sont conférés par le Sénat de McGill, je déclare que les candidats dont le nom figure sur la liste officielle des diplômés de l'université, qu'ils soient présents ou absents, ont satisfait aux exigences de leur grade, diplôme ou certificat respectif. By virtue of the powers conferred upon me by McGill's Senate, I declare that the candidates whose names appear on the university's official list of graduates, whether they be present or absent, have satisfied the requirements for their respective degrees, diplomas, or certificates. By tradition at McGill, we begin with the students receiving their graduate degrees, followed by students who are obtaining an undergraduate degree. And I now invite Professor Rosalie Duke here to present the graduates. Congratulations to the class of 2023. Félicitations.
It is my great pleasure to read the names of the students in this year's graduating class. Please note that prizes, scholarships, and honors earned by individual students are listed in your online programs. Mr. Chancellor Emeritus, for the degree of Doctor of Civil Law in Law, Miroslav Sadovsky. Vishaka Vijanayake. Upasana Dasgupta. For the degree of Master of Laws in Air and Space Law, Tomogana Agusti. Anna Bayer Pedrazzi. Ishat Chala. Liz Fallier. Siokte Kang. For the degree of Master of Laws in Law, Dina Alzaubi. Mashami Batarji. Rahul Christofferson. Yi Hong Huang. Amanda McCarthy. Maria Rodriguez. Christopher Savoy. Melisandre Shanks. For the degrees of Bachelor of Civil Law and Juris Doctor, Khadija Ahmed. Megan Albert. Ayelet Ami. Maria Angelidis. Michelle Aronson. Danielle Arsenault. Darian Berry. Shamir Isabelle Baptiste. Chloe Barrett. Catherine Beaulieu. Sammy Bendayan. Ian Bernstein. Cassandra Betts. Keegan Blackmore. Christopher Blakeney. Melissa Boder. Brandon Bonin. Megan Boyer. Johan Brake. Emma Rijan Braley. Emma Brown. Adam Bruder Wexler. Alexandra Champagne. Sandrine Charbonneau. Christopher Chaffro. Tessa Clark. Isabelle Côté. Laurent Côté de la Grave. Vincent Couteau. Shade Cousins. Emily Crompton. Janelle Denisse. Laura Doual Payan. Catherine Dunn. Talia Ejidian. Alea Espinoza. Dylan Fenton. Pierre-Olivier Furcault. Laura Ferns. Joshua Fitchman Goldberg. Camilla Franco. Mariana Gallegos Dupuis. Pierre William Gaudry. Aretha Gelino. Gabrielle Genet. Sade George. Joshua Ginter. Billy Godbout. Nadia Gurachun. Marianne Goyette. Katrina Graham. Dominique Grégoire. Philippe Grenier. Philippe Gay. Rania Amdine. Simon Amel Genet. Andrew Hamilton. Connor Shiro Duncan Hasegawa. Amy Jeffrey All Medal. Goldberg Rafaela Hassan. Meg Hazacker. Samuel Elguero. Olivier Henripin. Julia Hornstein. Alyosha Huri. Christoph Ivancic. Justin Halea. Garima Karia, co-recipient, Principal David L. Johnston Medal. Carolina Kasparov. Mohan Huider. Linnea Kornhauser. Olivia Costin Cohen. Jacob Crane Paul. Julia Kuzinski. Theodora Lustein. Peter Little. Ashley Light. Emma Lodge. Jeremy Lawyer. Lu Xiaoyan. Augusto Luyan Ripoll Reigada. Alan Luo. Kaylin McCauley. Thiago Machado. Bernard Mafti. Danielle Maur. Hanif Masumif. Sandrine Masri. Marcus Matucci. Jean Meron Tiber, Elizabeth Torrance Gold Medal. Scott McDonough. Robin McDougall. Riley McMurray. Praksha Mehta. Emily Michelin. Ulia Miklis Polat. Brandon Montour. Kazumi Moore. Frederic Morin. Shauna Musimbi. Angela Nassar. Cassandra Niranjan. Geneviève Nevin. Susie Newing. Sarah Nixon co-recipient Principal David L. Johnston Medal. Chubby Nanembe. Audrey Parent. Nicholas Pino. Michel Poupard. Jordan Pin. Juliette Rigoli. Hannah Riosecco. Kiana St. Macari. Rose Savaria. Pushkar Siwarutan. Anita Sengupta. Alexander Shapiro. Abby Shine. Andrea Yanke Sim. Eamon Thomas Somerville. Amelia Souffrant. Ellen Spanigal. Savaline Cor Sur. Daniel Tomlin Watts. Georgia Terrio. Rachel Toop. Paulina Tosheva. Matthew C. Aiden Wall. Emma Walsh. Ruo Lan Wang. Emily Weidel. Bliss White. Nicole Whitmarsh. Taryn Wilkie. Maria Williams. Elizabeth Yu. Alessia Zenga. And Isabel Zwicker.
Thank you, Professor Tuker. Thank you for a great job in reading all the graduates' names. I now invite Khadija Ali Ahmed to say a few words on behalf of the graduating class.
Good afternoon, Chancellor, members of the Platform Party, fellow graduates, and guests. First, I want to express my deep gratitude to my fellow graduating peers for nominating me to speak this afternoon. These words are for you first. Second, thank you to our families, our friends, our educators, our mentors, our alumni, and our support systems. We arrived today because of your guidance, your generosity, and your light. You helped us complete this chapter. Back in 2020, we all knew that the next couple of years of law school would be formative, interesting, challenging, and surprising. But little did we know just how unprecedented, our favorite word from 2020, our law school journey would be. Regardless, reflecting on our time at the faculty reminds me of two timeless themes: flexibility and integrity. Because of the pandemic, we've all had to reimagine, both collectively and personally, what our law school experience would look like time and time again. Our class rose to the occasion, from taking Zoom classes to participating in virtual hybrid events to online recruitment for the first time. Most importantly, though, we united as a community and supported one another throughout this transition, despite social distancing, despite isolation, despite time zone differences, and changing curfew times here in Quebec, all while we navigated personal hardship, including grief and loss. At the same time, though, we found time to celebrate at outdoor picnics, even in the freezing cold and dark, laughed on Zoom private chats, studied together by creating group summaries. Our formidable class exemplifies flexibility and what it means to make lemonade and share a glass with your neighbor, too. As for the second timeless theme our journey reminds me of is integrity. Inside and outside our classes, we've seen how law permeates our existence everywhere, every day, all the time. Regardless, this cohort has stepped up against racism, transphobia, Islamophobia, and so much more. Showing up when needed, checking in on friends and classmates when no one was looking, and simply listening with open ears and an open heart. We know and have learned in our courses that law is life, is law, is life. And now it's up to us, as we walk down Peel, to stay the course outside of academia and use our law degrees to do good and be good every step of the way. Success does not come from any particular job title or any one particular sector. Success comes from your integrity, from our values and our character, from who we choose to be in every situation, and how we treat everyone who crosses our path. I conclude by saying this. This cohort is very special. No bias, obviously, but class of 2023, you are so resilient. Continue to flow with the times and stay rooted in what ultimately matters. I wish you continued success. I'm so excited to see where you'll all be in the future and all your future accomplishments. Inshallah, we did it! And above all, may we do more in the future for everyone here and beyond. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Khadija. Congratulations, and it's obvious to me that the class of 2023 not only is quite special, but also exercises impeccable judgment in choosing you as their valedictorian. So. Robert Leckie, Dean of the Faculty of Law, will now address the graduating class. Dean Leckie.
You did it. Whatever path brought you to today, your graduation is a glorious moment for the DCL, LLM, and BCLJD classes of 2023. And your professors and our admin staff celebrate this milestone with you. As it is for you, today's an intense day for us. Your profs have mixed feelings as we see you cross the stage, sporting jeweled Crocs, combat boots, and everything in between. We're grateful for what we learned from you and delight in your accomplishments. We may feel a bit sad because while McGill Law alumni have chances to reconnect around the world, we will miss seeing you in Chancellor Day Hall. Je continuerai de prendre des nouvelles de plusieurs d'entre vous sur LinkedIn de plus en plus. À titre de diplômé, vous parviendrez plus ou moins facilement, disons-le, à me tutoyer. Et maintenant, un mot pour votre entourage. Merci d'avoir appuyé et encouragé un être cher pendant ces études. Comme l'a mentionné le chancelier émérite, la promotion de 2023 a profité de la générosité des cohortes précédentes. Dans certains cas, afin de mieux vous équiper pour votre apprentissage virtuel. J'espère que vous saurez faire preuve de la même générosité lorsque vous serez en mesure de le faire, que ce soit comme bénévole ou donateur. Dans notre grande faculté, vous avez étudié et vécu le droit d'une manière unique. Vous nous quittez habilités à penser le droit différemment que les diplômés d'ailleurs, votre imagination ayant été stimulée par la sagesse de plus d'une tradition juridique. Vous avez été formé pour vous attaquer aux problèmes avec créativité. Vous êtes en mesure de gérer des situations qui traversent de nombreuses frontières et qui impliquent des règles provenant de nombreuses sources. La crise climatique en est l'exemple par excellence. Vous avez donc plusieurs cordes à votre arc qui vous permettront de briller dans des conditions incertaines et fluctuantes. During your time as law students, your passions and talents amazed and inspired my colleagues and me. You ran student-initiated seminars. You mooted, this year finally in person, managed scholarly journals, Contours, and the venerable Quid Novi. You offered legal information and worked for NGOs here and overseas, for law firms, governments, and judges. The LSA and GLSA helped in sustaining community during the Zoom School of Law, And they did a spectacular job reviving student life high on Peel Street. And what about Skit Night 2023? Yeah. As TLs and GAs, many of you accompanied first-year students in tough pandemic circumstances. Many of you played ping pong and foosball, enjoyed the piano in the atrium, and became fixtures at Thompson House. You engaged in activism and fostered community through groups such as the Indigenous Law Association, Dua Tuktan, Muslim Law Students Association, Jewish Law Students Association, Christian Law Students Association, Black Law Students Association of McGill, McGill Business Law Association, DALA, and RADLAW. You pedaled in the Christie bike ride and engaged with high school students through our LEX program. Many of you handled paid work and caregiving, and as Khadija hinted, including dealing with illness or loss. I salute your energy, tenacity, adaptability, and courage. And I'm so glad you experienced a semester or two of this year's full-on return to a vibrant life in Chancellor Day Hall, including Coffee House. Tout comme vous, notre faculté évolue constamment. Plus que jamais, notre corps professoral brille, tant à McGill qu'ailleurs. Je salue mes collègues qui ont été honorés aujourd'hui, tout en rappelant que deux autres ont reçu des prix universitaires cette année. Rosalie Jukier a reçu le prix Morty Yalovsky pour l'ensemble des réalisations et l'excellence dans le leadership académique. Yeah. Et Sébastien Jodoin, pour sa part, a reçu le prix Acteur de changement sous l'égide du prix du principal pour le rayonnement du savoir dans les médias et auprès du public. Quant au cursus, le choix des cours intensifs des Focus Week reflète vos préférences et vos critiques. En automne 2020, certains d'entre vous ont été parmi les premiers à suivre le cours de tradition juridique autochtone. Le cours de Critical Race Theory s'est par ailleurs implanté. Des cours en droit de la vie privée et en intelligence artificielle sont devenus des incontournables. Your time as a law student has seen reminders of our world's need for more justice. And here I think of Madame Taubira's words as well as Khadija's. Marches for the climate, protests against anti-black racism, Bill 21, and transphobia, and violent acts, including those of anti-Asian racism, anti-Semitism, and Islamophobia. Many of you have protested and organized for these causes and others. With your legal education, including sensitivity to social context, you are set to speak out in places of power. Honor the voices and spirits of those who are silenced for whatever reason. I urge you to listen carefully and respectfully to those whose views differ from yours. Try to understand their starting points and see their positions in their best light. Doing so will help you, whether you aim to persuade them of your position, as lawyers, or as lawyers often do, to find a solution that meets divergent needs. Looking ahead, you will change jobs more often than previous generations. So if you have a job already, congratulations. It's your next job, not your last. And if you haven't got one, that's okay too. Many, many of our alumni found or fashioned fulfilling paths outside standard recruitment, and in many cases took their McGill education far from traditional legal practice. And alumni often tell me how keen they are to hear from fellow members of the McGill law community. So don't be shy about reaching out. While some say there are too many lawyers, our world faces many challenges towards which engaged citizens with legal training, you, have much to offer. Many wicked challenges hold work for institution builders, regulators, and mediators. We see reminders here and abroad that democracy, the separation of powers, the protection of minorities, and the rule of law are fragile. Lawyers' work is changing fast. The pandemic dragged a paper-based profession into, well, at least the late 20th century, and it's too soon to know what artificial intelligence will mean to your work and for mine. Ask what these changes will mean and adjust your path to them. Now, we know that our profession is beset by difficulties, including stress, substance abuse, and family breakdown. Legal leaders have broken the silence surrounding problems with mental health, and your generation will do its part. Take time to care for yourselves, your loved ones, and one another, so that you can, in turn, care for the world. Much about your future is unknown. Still, by now you probably know your core values and your strengths. You have an evolving conception of justice. Be true to all of that. Reevaluate periodically, and don't be afraid to course correct. Outside school, with no graduation date, deciding when to leap is only up to you. And honestly, I hear more regrets about waiting too long than about changing too soon. My colleagues and I wish you great success, however you define and measure it. When you fail, as you will because we all fail, apologize when appropriate and don't stay down for long. When you pick yourself up, may you draw the lessons waiting for you and may your bruises heal swiftly. Bravo à chacun et à chacune. Vous nous manquez déjà, alors donnez-nous de vos nouvelles et revenez nous voir souvent. Nous sommes tellement fiers de vous.
Thank you, Dean Leckie. Will the graduating class please stand? Je demande à tous les diplômés de se lever. À titre de chancelier émérite de l'Université McGill, je déclare et confirme que chacun de vous a maintenant le droit à la distinction de grade, diplôme ou certificat qui vous a été conféré avec tous les honneurs, droits, privilèges et responsabilités qui y sont rattachés. In my capacity as Chancellor Emeritus of McGill, I declare and confirm that each of you is now entitled to the distinction of the degree, diploma, or certificate that has been conferred upon you, with all the honors, rights, privileges, and responsibilities that are pertinent thereto. Félicitations, congratulations. The best is yet to come, and as a taste of that, the Secretary General, Edita Rogowska, will now make a few closing remarks.
Merci, Monsieur le Chancelier, chers diplômés. En terminant notre cérémonie, j'aimerais vous laisser avec quelques mots du poète et écrivain Rainer Maria Rilke, qui nous offre quelques pensées formulées comme suit. Be patient towards all that remains unresolved in your heart. Let your judgments have their own undisturbed development, which must, like all human progress, come from deep within and which cannot in any way be pressed or hurried. So I offer these words to you in the hope that as you leave McGill, you will take the time that you need to reflect upon the questions and the causes that are important to you, and then that you will use everything that you have gained through your journey at McGill to pursue them and to make a positive contribution to your community and the world. En vous souhaitant le meilleur des succès, je vous dis bonne chance et félicitations encore une fois.
Pour conclure la cérémonie, veuillez vous lever afin d'entonner en compagnie du professeur Trevino, l'hymne national du Canada. To conclude the ceremony, please stand and join Professor Trevino in the singing of our national anthem.
With glowing hearts we see thee
rise, the true north, strong and free. Ta istuaret in hippopyr, de plibrios exploit.